Hello friends, welcome once again to the AFOSOP Video Tool Series, a presentation by the Academy for Life Skills Development, Pune. Today, I'll suggest you some books that I'll request you to read for the purpose of self-development. Also, there were many requests on this on the YouTube comment box as well as on the WhatsApp and on the Prapathon video channel, AFOSOP channel. So I thought I'll make this video, which is long pending. Now, just to give you background, now, you know, in the PIQ, there's a video understanding PIQ. There is a column in that where hobbies and interests have to be written. And this PIQ form is available with the psychologist and the interviewing officer. And besides the psychological, also get the self-description of the individual as part of the psychological test. And the interviewing officer, besides the PIQ, he has the CIQ, which is specifically on spare time, interest, hobbies and games. Now, a video on this has been uploaded very recently. For the last video was this. Now, the interviewing officer has the possibility of cross-examining both the CIQ as well as what you speak on the CIQ. So he can cross-question on the PIQ as well as on the CIQ, whereas the psychologist does not cross-question. He gets those inputs in terms of his assessment of the TAT, WAT, SRT, and of course correlating with the SD, and both of them are looking for congruence. What does it mean? What is the truth behind what you're communicating? So not necessarily that everything you write in the PIQ and everything you speak on the CIQ is going to be true. So they know that there is a phase and they want to penetrate through that phase. What I'm trying to say is, instead of wearing a mukhota, even if you don't have a hobby oblique interest, it'll be very honest on your part to say that I don't have an hobby so far, sir, but off late about 2-3 months, I've started reading some books, because that's the easiest thing that you can develop. So with that regard, I will suggest you some books, and I'm sure within the next 2-3 months, you will be able to, you know, finish off 2-3 of them, or maybe a little more of them, and work on it thoroughly, understand it thoroughly, and you should be able to give a summary of it, what things that you could implement it on your own self, and how could it help you in understanding it. And the aim is that you should leave this mukhota anywhere they want to take it out. That I'm sure you would have got it as part of the intra-technique and inter-technique congruence and all those things that I've conveyed through the previous 2-3 videos. So the aim is, can you be honest and say that I've started reading books off late, and these are the 3 or 4 or 5 whatever books that I've read, and go through it thoroughly. So we'll see some of the books. So I'll request you to take out a piece of paper and pen, and wherever I show you, you can pause it, write the name of the book and the author, and subsequently you can go to the internet and either look for PDF books, or you can purchase also. So no harm investing something on yourself rather than, you know, mukhota pen case SSB. That's the aim. So no pinky ponky, we'll go honestly to the SSB. So the first book I'll suggest is, it is The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen R. Covey. And it's a very powerful book. In fact, all the books that I'm going to show you here, all the books, I have personally read it, not only read it, I've read some of the books, I've read it multiple times. And many of the concepts that I'm using in the AFOSOP are probably from some of these books. So I'm not putting any book that I've not read. So please go through it. The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People from Stephen R. Covey, right? And there's another book from the same person, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Teens. So this is for teenagers. So if you are a teenager, that is 9, 10, 11, 12, or maybe 10 plus 2 TA centric, this book will be more relevant to you than the previous one. So this is by, Stephen Covey's son, that is Sean Covey. So this is a book. Next is Wings of Fire, our own very, you know, popular and very dear ex-president APJ Abdul Kalam. Wings of Fire, very popular book. He has also made a reference of his experience at the selection board at Dehradun in this book. Another book by APJ Abdul Kalam is India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium. So I suggest you go through the third book by APJ Abdul Kalam, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Ignited Minds, Unleashing the Power Within India. So it is his vision for the India. Go through that. Tremendous possibilities to expand your, you know, thinking capacities. Next, a very popular book, The Secret. Many of you would have watched it. There are movie on this by Rhonda Byrne, right? Next is by Kiran Bedi, I Dare, a fantastic book, and I think all educated women, even if you take a Hindi version of it, you must go for it. And in fact, all boys must learn from this book, I Dare. What a phenomenal leadership capacities potential she has shown. She belongs to a time when there were a lot of restrictions in women, and she has come out of all those things. Excellent support from her parents and all those things. So fantastic story of leadership, and excellent for both boys and girls. I Dare by Kiran Bedi. Next is Count Your Chicken Before They Hatch. This is by Arindam Chaudhary. I don't know if you know, there is an institute called Indian Institute of Planning and Management. So he's one of the board of directors of that. So read this book, Count Your Chicken Before They Hatch. Right. Next is an Indian NRA, Robin Sharma, the monk who sold his Ferrari. A fable about fulfilling your dreams and reaching your destiny. Fantastic book. Extremely popular in the Western world, and simply written as a journey of a lawyer who had a heart attack, and then how does he go through the entire journey. So Indian spirituality has been put into a different context, so go through it. Next is by the same author, The Leader Who Had No Title. So I keep telling, whether in the SSB or on life, there are two types of leaders. One are positional leaders, one are personal leaders. So he's talking about personal leadership. So a leader with no title, yet he is a leader. How? So in case of if you wish to build your personal capacities, fantastic book, The Leader Who Had No Title, Robin Sharma. Next is You Can Win. Again, an Indian author, a very simply written book and extremely simple to understand. There are videos on this. You can go to the YouTube and get a lot of stuff about it. Even the PDF copy is available. If you don't find, send me a mail, I'll give it to you. You Can Win. Winners don't do different things. They do things differently. So there are so many people who are preparing for SSB. So there is no dearth of people who are involved in training also. But unless you change your input, you cannot change your output. Look at this. Winners don't do different things. They do things differently. Even the approach of AFOSOP you will find is completely different from the rat race. So there are so many competition for being number one. AFOSOP is today the only one. There's no competition because it is a process-oriented training. By the time people built it up, this would have been gone far ahead. So this book is fantastic and simply written by Shiv Khera, our own Indian author. Next is How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. It's a very popular book, and this will tremendously help you to build up your factor two qualities, that is social adaptability, cooperation, sense of responsibility, communication skills and all that. How to Win Friends and Influence People, Dale Carnegie. Now this is another book, Inspiration. Look at the human possibilities. Agar aapko khud pe vishwas aa jaye to sky is the limit. In fact, you can even go beyond sky. Now this is a book written by a person, Nick Vujicic. Net pe marna na haath hai na paon hai, but he's doing miraculously well. I have all his books and I've read all of them. Very simply read, and it talks about the way the spiritual powers or the inner powers, when it is powered up, how can you achieve miracles? Life without limits. Look at this. But this person wanted to commit suicide sometime. Jab shuru shuru mein bahut depress ho gaya tha ki ye kya na haath hai na paav hai, but he could not even succeed in committing suicide because haath paav nahi the, bach gaya. So then he said ki there must be some reason for my existence, and look at this phenomenal story. He's an entrepreneur, he's a motivational speaker, he's a relationship counselor, he's an inspiration to many people with us who have got both legs and arms, yet not able to achieve anything because shy energy is not directed. Nick Vujicic, Life Without Limits. Next book is No Arms, No Legs, No Worries, again by Nick Vujicic. Na haath na paav aur na koi chinta. That is a phenomenally powerful book, and it talks about circle of influence and circle of concern. When you focus your energy on your circle of concern, it expands, and it also reduces your capacity to perform because it shrinks your circle of influence. Whereas if you put your emphasis on circle of influence, that grows, and even the concerns are diminished because your energy is concentrated on what is within your control. So if this concept ko aap SSB ki taiyari ke liye lagao rather than ratta patta marne ki, you find your possibilities expanding phenomenally. So these are some of the tools that I'm using in the AFOSOP training module. So once you come here, you'll realize. Next is by Edward D. Bono, that is How to Have a Beautiful Mind. Today our mind is the biggest problem. It rambles between the present and the past. Kabhi past mein jaake kachra nikal ke lata hai, dard lata hai, and many times it goes into the future and creates anxiety. It rambles between the two extremes. It is constantly under oscillation between the past and the present. It is not able to stay in its present position. Is oscillation ko band karna पड़ेगा, मिनिमाइज करना पड़ेगा ऑसिलेशन बिटवीन द पास्ट एंड द फ्यूचर. पास्ट से पेन लाता, फ्यूचर में एंग्जाइटी, इसे ला के प्रेजेंट में खड़ा करना है, बिकॉज दैट इज वॉट इज विद इन आर कंट्रोल. सो दिस बुक्स टॉक्स अबाउट हाउ टू have a beautiful mind. Next, a beautiful book is The Power of Your Subconscious Mind. In fact, many of the concepts that I use here for Zupi May as part of your training model are application of some of the concepts that are given here. So even people who are involved in coaching center, I think ratta patta chhodo de sara, agar aap is pe align karte ho, students will benefit. So please look at this. There's tremendous possibilities inside, but us possibility ko tap karna padega bajaye ki outside ka gift wrapping change karne ke liye. I'll suggest you watch this video. The next book I will suggest is The Magic of Thinking Big. This book will help you to grow, outgrow your, you know, limited thinking. Bahut narrow hum TATWAT mein ulajh gaye, hum beej bo nahi rahe hain lekin hum phal ki kalpana kar rahe hain. Hum बचपन, अगर आम का पेड़ चाहिए और आम का फल चाहिए तो 10 साल पहले बोना चाहिए था. हम बीज नहीं बो रहे आज, और हम आज कीकर के पेड़ से आम की कल्पना कर रहे थे, एंड ऐसे ट्रेनिंग भी हो रही है. नाउ दिस इज वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट. सो इफ यू वांट टू अचीव समथिंग देयर हैज टू बी कंसिस्टेंट एफर्ट, बट अ डायरेक्टेड एफर्ट. सो दिस बुक विल गिव यू ट्रेमेंडस पॉसिबिलिटी. देयर इज एन ऑडियो बुक ऑल्सो अवेलेबल विथ मी, सो इन केस इफ यू नीड यू कैन सेंड मी अ मेल एट afosop@gmail.com. सो दिस इज एन ऑडियो बुक एंड आई वुड हैव हर्ड दिस बुक फॉर एटलीस्ट 6 to 7 टाइम्स. ऑडियो बुक ऐसे कान में लगा दो, इट्स इंस्पायर्स, ये आग लगाता है आपके अंदर. द नेक्स्ट बुक आई सजेस्ट इज द पावर ऑफ पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग, नॉर्मन विंसेंट. ना बहुत सारे हम लोग सब कोचिंग में जितने भी इन्वॉल्व है सब आपको पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग बोलते हैं, बट इतना गलत एक कॉन्सेप्ट दे देते हैं आपको कि डेड बॉडी को ड्रामा बनाना है इस पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग, रोते हुए फिगर को पॉजिटिव बना दो, उसको हंसता हुआ बना दो. ये सब पॉजिटिव थिंकिंग नहीं है. सकारात्मक थिंकिंग क्या है, आप इस बुक को पढ़ो, और जो AFOSOP का वो चैनल है, नॉट द चैनल, द वीडियो जिसमें कि क्लासिफिकेशन, साइकोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ थॉट्स, उसमें भी दिया हुआ है. आई विल बी मेकिंग मोर वीडियोस ऑन दैट. सो जो आपको SSB का बी पॉजिटिव कॉन्सेप्ट बिल्कुल डिस्टॉर्ट कर दिया है कोचिंग के प्रोसेस में या इंटरनेट के थ्रू, सो आई विल रिक्वेस्ट टू वॉच दिस. यू नो, सिचुएशन इज नॉट पॉजिटिव नेगेटिव, सिचुएशन इज सिचुएशन. आप उस सिचुएशन को किस तरीके से हैंडल करते हो और उसका आउटकम कहाँ लेके जाते हो, दैट मेक्स इट पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव, ना कि डेड बॉडी को ड्रामा बनाना. सो दिस विल एक्सप्लेन यू दोज थिंग्स. द नेक्स्ट बुक इज जैक कैनफील्ड का द सक्सेस प्रिंसिपल, हाउ टू गेट फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर टू वेयर यू वॉन्ट टू बी. यू नो, आप अभी जहाँ पे हो और कहाँ पहुँचना चाहते हो, इस डिस्टेंस को कैसे कवर करना है और इसके बीच के बैरियर्स को कैसे एड्रेस करना है, ये बुक, ये इसमें बहुत प्यारे तरीके से दिया हुआ था. सक्सेस प्रिंसिपल, हाउ टू गेट फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर टू वेयर यू वांट टू बी. डेफिनेटली इन टर्म्स ऑफ SSB, यू वांट टू बिकम अ कमीशन ऑफिसर, बट द जर्नी इज लॉन्ग एंड स्टर्नियस. TATWAT ठीक करने से नहीं होगा, इस बुक को पढ़ो, अपने आप को अंदर से ठीक करना पड़ेगा. जब आप सुधरोगे आपका रिस्पॉन्स सुधर जाएगा. So this book is another phenomenal book. Next is the original Chicken Soup for the Soul. Now this is to purify your emotional dimension, to purify your value system. Bahut zabardast book hai, and there are various other books by this same author, but I'll suggest you to read this Chicken Soup for the Soul. And next is Awaken the Giant Within You. You know, aapke andar ke us potential ko tap karo. उसको पोटेंशियल को टैग करके जब उसको यूज करना शुरू करोगे, आपको किसी कोचिंग की जरूरत ना मेरी ना किसी और की, बिकॉज यू आर इंटरनली ड्रिवन. राइट नाउ यू किक स्टार्ट, यू हैव टू बिकम पुश स्टार्ट. ये आपको बहुत मदद करेगा ये बुक, है ना. अवेकन द जायंट विद इन यू, टॉनी रॉबिन्स का बुक है ये. हाउ टू टेक इमीडिएट कंट्रोल ऑफ योर मेंटल, इमोशनल, फिजिकल एंड फाइनेंशियल डेस्टिनी. फाइनेंशियल को छोड़ो, बाकी तीनों को तो करना है. सो प्लीज टेक केयर ऑफ योर ओन सेल्फ, दिस बुक विल हेल्प यू फॉर दैट. The next book is How to Stop Worrying and Start Living. है ना, डेल कॉलेज का अनदर बुक. सो ये चिंता विंता करना छोड़ दो, SSB में क्या होगा सर, ये तो पूछ रहे, पावर ऑफ एक्सप्रेशन कमजोर है मेरा, कॉन्फिडेंस, ये सब चिंता विंता छोड़ दो. चिंता करोगे तो चिंता बढ़ जाएगी. चिंता चिता समान, छोड़ो इसे. आप ये देखो कि क्या चीज करना है जिससे ये चिंता के कारणों को जड़ से मिटा दूंगा. सो दिस बुक विल गिव यू ट्रेमेंडस पॉसिबिलिटीज टू डू दैट. अनदर बुक आई सजेस्ट इज Who Moved My Cheese. है ना, दिस इज अनदर ब्यूटिफुल बुक जहाँ पे दो चूहों के ऊपर ये पूरी कहानी बनाई हुई. एक चूहा जो बहुत मेहनत करता था, एक जो बिल्कुल निकम्मा था, और इन दोनों की कहानी और कैसे इन दोनों का सेम अपॉर्चुनिटी होते हुए कैसे एक बर्बाद हो गया और कैसे एक एकदम सक्सेसफुल हो गया. ब्यूटीफुल रिटन बुक, हु मूव्ड माई चीज, वेरी पॉपुलर बुक, सो आई रिक्वेस्ट यू वॉच दिस. सो एफर्ट्स के ऊपर बात करता है, कंसिस्टेंट एफर्ट. मेनी अ टाइम जो आप एफर्ट कर रहे हो उसका रिजल्ट अभी नहीं मिलेगा, इट बी सम टाइम लेटर. नेक्स्ट इज अ ब्यूटीफुल बुक, द पावर ऑफ नाउ. है ना, किसी भी आर्ट को करना है यू हैव टू एक्ट इट इमीडिएटली रादर देन प्रोक्रास्टिनेटिंग. हम क्या करते हैं, कंफर्ट जोन में फंस जाते हैं. कंफर्ट जोन मतलब समझो एक तरीके से करते करते उसके अंदर उलझ जाते, उससे बाहर नहीं जाना चाहते बिकॉज उसमें बहुत मेहनत है. बट ऑल ग्रोथ हैपेंस बियॉन्ड द कंफर्ट जोन. सो दिस बुक द पावर ऑफ नाउ विल हेल्प यू टू पुश यू आउटसाइड योर कंफर्ट जोन. सो वॉच दिस बुक. द नेक्स्ट बुक इज द 1 मिनट मैनेजर. द 1 मिनट मैनेजर विल टेल यू छोटे छोटे चीज़ों को, छोटे छोटे डिसीजन को हम कैसे क्विकली कर सकते हैं, कैसे एक मौका मिलता है अप्रिशिएट करना, कैसे किसी को कम्युनिकेट करना, कैसे किसी को आइडिया को लेके कैसे करना. मतलब इट टॉक्स अबाउट इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, क्विक इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ व्हाट आवर आइडिया कम. 1 मिनट मैनेजर बहुत अच्छा बुक है. इस पतला सा बुक है, छोटा सा, इसको आप एक दिन में भी खत्म कर सकते हो. द 1 मिनट मैनेजर. द नेक्स्ट बुक इज द रोड लेस ट्रैवल. देखो भैया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल SSB की ट्रेनिंग है, रट्टा मार कोचिंग तो बहुत हो गया है. That is called target oriented. The road less traveled is एक बार AFOSOP approach को भी try करके तो देखो. It is the road less traveled as far as this is concerned. But it talks about beaten path. भेड़ चाल तो सब चला सकते हैं, शेर की चाल चलो जो अपने आप चलता. This road will take you to the untrodden paths and give you the inner power to push yourself into those क्या बोलते हैं एक ऐसे रास्ते पे जिसमें ज़्यादा लोग चले नहीं हैं. AFOSOP का भी अप्रोच जो है कुछ ना कुछ इस बुक से बहुत मोटिवेटेड है. द रोड लेस ट्रैवल्ड, प्रोसेस ओरिएंटेड ट्रेनिंग, टारगेट ओरिएंटेड को बंद. समझ में आ रहा क्या बोल रहा है? एंड यू कैन सी द इम्पैक्ट ऑफ दिस इन द वीडियोस. द नेक्स्ट बुक आई विल सजेस्ट इज दिस बुक विल हेल्प यू टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑपोजिट जेंडर. यू नो दिस मे नॉट बी वेरी रिलेवेंट टू द इंडियन कॉन्टेक्स्ट बिकॉज दिस इज अ वेस्टर्न बुक. तो बट बहुत सारे कल्चर्स जो है इंडिया के साथ मैच नहीं होता है. बट इमोशनल लेवल पे वेदर इट्स अ वेस्टर्न और ह्यूमन इमोशंस आर ह्यूमन इमोशन, वेदर ए इंडियन और अफ्रीकन और यूके और USA पर्सन. सो ह्यूमन इमोशन एंड स्पेशली ऑपोजिट जेंडर को समझने के लिए. मैनी टाइम्स वेन पिक्चर में देयर इज अ फीमेल, देयर इज अ मेल, देयर आर डिफरेंट इमोशंस, तो कभी कभी हम कंफ्यूज रहते हैं कैसे करना है. एंड देयर इज अनदर वन क्वेश्चन कि इफ देयर इज अ फीमेल कैरेक्टर इन द TAT पिक्चर, शुड आई ब्रिंग अ कैरेक्टर फ्रॉम आउटसाइड. एंड आई कीप सेइंग एंड अदर्स ऑल्सो समटाइम्स से कि मेंटेन योर जेंडर इंटीग्रिटी. इसका मतलब आप अगर मेल हो तो सी दैट यू ब्रिंग अ मेल कैरेक्टर, ऑफ यूर फीमेल, ऑल दोज थिंग्स. सो ये क्यों ऐसे बोलते हैं? बिकॉज आर द इंटरनल वायरिंग, इमोशनल वायरिंग ऑफ मेल एंड फीमेल different. Male is left brain heavy, that is rational, whereas females are right brain heavy, that is emotional. So this book will tell you from John Gray, men are from Mars, women are from Venus. And I think this book, you must read it before you get married. It may not be 100% relevant to Indian context, but it will give you tremendous amount of understanding how to kya bolte interact with the opposite gender. If you are a male by female, इसमें बहुत एक अच्छी चीज़ जो एक जगह पे लिखी थी, मेरे को ध्यान नहीं कहाँ पे, उसमें एक चीज़ लिखा था, when you interact with a female, please make sure you don't hurt your sentiments. When you interact with a female, please make sure you do not hurt her sentiments. The females are emotional. And उसमें लिखा हुआ है, when you interact with male, for females के लिए advice is, when you interact with male, please make sure you don't hurt his ego. For him, ego is important. A beautiful book, इसको ज़रा समझना और पढ़ना. Another book I'll suggest to you is, now this is for your spiritual growth. When aajkal hamare lust based thinking bahut zyada ho gaya, lust matlab suno jo kaam bhav by Paramahansa Yogananda, very popular not only India mein across, but it's not very easy to understand aur ye bahut slow moving book hai, isko aap speed se nahi pad sakte. The cost of the book is very less, but the volume of the knowledge is so deep. The book is autobiography of a yogi. इसको नेट पे भी आप मार के इसको थोड़ा सा रिव्यू भी देख सकते हो. सो ये थोड़ा हैवी बुक है, बट इसको पढ़ने से पहले इसका बुक रिव्यू पढ़ लेना चैप्टर वाइज, तो आपको ये समझ में आ जाएगा वॉट इज ई कम्युनिकेटिंग इन एवरी चैप्टर. बट फिनॉमनली गुड बुक टू क्लीन योर इनर कॉन्शियस. मैं बोलता ना अंदर से आलू, सड़ा हुआ आलू साफ करना. सड़ा हुआ आलू साफ करने के बहुत सारे गुण इसमें मिलेंगे. आई एम यूजिंग लॉट ऑफ टूल्स फ्रॉम दिस बुक, सो आई थिंक यू कैन गो थ्रू इट. है ना, यू ऑल कीप आस्किंग कि सर ये Q3 कैसे खाली करना, दिस बुक विल हेल्प यू इन दैट. इसके अलावा टू अंडरस्टैंड ह्यूमन लाइफ एंड इनवर्ड लुकिंग, है ना, लाइफ के कॉन्सेप्ट को, एंड इफ यू बिलीव इन द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ रीबर्थ एंड ऑल दोस, दिस इज स्पिरिचुअल डायमेंशन, बट इट हेल्प्स यू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ लाइफ. है ना, मेनी लाइव्स मेनी मास्टर्स, मतलब ये सोल जो है, रीइनकार्नेशन ऑफ सोल, ये सोल ट्रांसफर होता रहता है अलग अलग बॉडी bodies may, although it is about the Punarjan Kevpara by Brian West. So it's a very, very popular book written by Vesna. Another book is Life After Life. It's written by Dr. Raman A. Moody. Iska reference, all these books I have made a reference in the one of the assisted introspections. These references, part one mein Aishat. So Life After Life, a beautiful book written by a doctor. This book mein near-death experience walo ka account hai. Yani ki clinically the patients were declared dead, but after 15 minutes, 20 minutes, some cases half an hour, they were alive again. Is antaral mein, when they were declared clinically death or maybe medically they were dead, but they again came back to life. Is duration mein jo hua, wo account hai isme. And a doctor is writing, so credibility bahut acha. Just look at this. Indian Punarjanm ke upar jaisa, aisa lage usi ke upar hai. So beautiful book if you believe in all those things, or even if you don't believe. Now this is another person, Anita Murjani, NRI, Hong Kong based Indian NRI hai. And she was a terminally fourth stage ki cancer patient thi, and dying to be me. So she also had a near death experience. My journey from cancer to near death to true healing. Or fourth stage cancer se char din mein she became completely healed because of some spiritual activity. So your book, a normal person ne likha hua, she is not no author, no speaker, but then that event transformed her. And fantastically beautiful book again to clean your sada hua aloo from inside. Aap isko jarur padhna, isko internet pe bhi check kar sakte ho. Anita Murjani, Dying to be Me. And another book I will suggest you is by Louis L. Hay, You Can Heal Your Life. You know, many of us are in multiple conflicts, relationship conflict, kabhi sala mummy papa se conflict, kabhi personal conflict, kabhi all kind of conflict, kabhi profession ko leke, and we don't know how to heal with it. Injuries inside, dard hai, raat ko sote to wo dard takleef deta hai. How to heal it at a spiritual level? I told you I am a marriage counselor and a spiritual healer also, and I'm a speaker for Brahma Kumari. So a lot of concepts that I take from here. So this book is a phenomenally good book to emotionally and psychologically heal yourself for those people who are carrying pain inside them. Because unless you clean them, aap ke andar balance nahi aayega. Before you go for SSB, you must achieve that balance. So these are some of the books that I thought I will suggest you. And in the next video, based on the feedback I get on this, I will also recommend you some war movies. You know, World War II ke time, a lot of war movies came. Some Indian movies also. Unko aap dekhoge to uske central character, hero ko dekhna, and you will be able to identify and see how the OLQs, jo hum SSB mein dekhte hai, they are seen in actual military situations. But they are all magnified situation, bigger situation, but you have to model them onto day-to-day activities. Pooth ke paon palne mein. To agar aapke andar wo gun hai, to dikhenge. Ratne patne se nahi hoga. So I'll suggest you this movie, provided you feel that they would be worth. So I'll make it here. And those of you who want to attend the AFOSOP Leadership and Personality Development Program, it's starting on every Monday. The next is starting on 20th of November, that is person. And these are the numbers on which you can send me a WhatsApp message, and an email can be sent at afosop@gmail.com. अपने कमेंट्स को जरूर इस फीडबैक बॉक्स में डालना, कमेंट बॉक्स में यूट्यूब के, शेयर करना अपने दोस्तों के साथ, और सब्सक्राइब जरूर कर लेना, बिकॉज यू वुड हैव सीन आई हैव इंक्रीज द रेट ऑफ सब्सक्रिप्शन मूवी मेकिंग वीडियो मेकिंग. सो आई हैव डिसाइडेड टू डेफिनेटली अपलोड टू वीडियोज एवरी वीक. सो इंस्टेंट नोटिफिकेशन मिलेगा. योर कमेंट्स विल बी इंकरेजिंग. यू हैव बीन लुकिंग फॉर दिस वीडियो फॉर क्वाइट सम टाइम, एंड आई मेड इट बेस्ड ऑन योर रिक्वेस्ट, एंड आई होप दिस बुक्स विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प यू टू हैंडल many of your life conflicts, and also it will help you to cover up yourself in the CIQ on hobbies and interests instead of kuch bhi satta marne ke. So I hope these videos are helping you, and may God bless you. Thank you very much. Thank you.